Okay, today I will be installing this equipment. This is a tankless water heater. The make of this one is Rinnai tankless water heater. Some people call it instantaneous water heater. Some call it on demand, and some call it endless water heater. That is due to the efficiency and the way the equipment works. Okay, so this machine, which is the tankless water heater, I will be removing these two tank. These are 50 gallon US power vented. So these two water tank, I will be removing them, and then I will be replacing it with a Rinnai tankless water heater, or you call it a tankless water heater. Okay. Now there are four basic things I always want to have in the back of my mind when I'm installing a tankless water heater. So those four basic things, number one is venting. So venting is very, very important. So when you are installing a tankless water heater, make sure you are venting it as per the code of the community or the city, and also as per the manufacturer specification. Secondly, is the gas line. The gas line has to be properly sized to meet the equipment standard. Otherwise, you won't get all those functions we're talking about, the on-demand, the endless. You won't be able to get it. So it's good you size your gas line. And number three is your water, the water coming in. You need to also look at the water coming in to be properly sized. Make sure you are getting a good flow of water coming in. And then number four will be a good installation. So if you do a good install, yes, this machine will really last really well and last longer, and you will get the efficiency that you have it for. Thank you. So as the job progresses, we'll be updating this information. Thank you. Okay, as the job progresses, so far the vent is taken off here, and the water inlet and water outlet is all taken out. Okay, on both units, the gas line is disconnected here. Both gas lines are disconnected, so we're just waiting for the water to be completely drained, and once it is drained, then we'll take this tank out. So one thing I want to explain again, I said the gas supply is very important. So as I will, here is 50 US gallon, 50 US gallon. So that's 50,000 BTU, 50,000 BTU. So that's 100. Estimation, this is like 90,000 BTU heating gas furnace. And the homeowner has a gas stove of about 50,000 BTU. So 50 here, 50 here, 100 plus 90, which is 190, plus the home cooking stove, which is gas, and that is like 250. And also the homeowner has two gas fireplace, so that's like 44,000 BTU plus already 250, 190, that's 50, 100, 190 plus the gas to 60, 250 plus another 80, almost 350. We are approaching that now. So if your gas meter is not fully sized, or the gas line is not fully sized, you won't be able to put in the tankless. So you need to be able to come up with, make sure you check with your gas supply, how much is your gas meter is allowed to go in, So if your gas meter, for example, is sized at 250,000 BTU, so you need to upgrade your gas meter so you can get more gas flow to your tank. So if I already have 350, so if I take 100 of these two out, so I'm left with 250. And remember, my tankless. So my tankless here is approximately 200, okay, approximately 200 BTU. So 200 plus 250, you're looking at about 450 already. So therefore, it's very important that your gas line is properly sized, and your gas meter, please call the distributor of your gas and verify what is the size of your gas meter, so you don't have to run out of gas in the process, okay? So that's something I want to explain to my co-technician. And also, please, again, I said water flow is very important, and then venting with good installation. Thank you. Okay, the tankless water heater is installed. Look at how much room left now. Two tank removed and very, very spacious. And you can see the tankless is installed. Here, like I earlier mentioned, venting is very, very important, okay? So the venting is all done as per the code. This is inside of the unit, but I'm gonna cover it. But before then, I'm gonna say something here before I do that. So again, this is a service valve, okay? This is the hot water in and the cold water. And here are the service valve that needs to be put in. Very, very compulsory that it should be put in as per the manufacturer. The reason for this is that when you want to service the unit, you can easily service it without no problem. So again, I also talk about water flow. You can see quora inlet and quora outlet. So very, very important. And again, the gas line here, see quora inlet and same all quora. So you do that to get good flow. Okay, so good installation is very important. So now that the unit has been installed, so I take out the cover here. And I want to make sure that everything here is okay, secured. My vent motor is secure. Some people may ask, why did you take it out? Yes, the manufacturer recommended it is the installers to look at it to make sure everything is okay. If you don't look at it, you don't check if your vent motor is wobbling, if you are having any leak, and you just cover it, install it, and you go. And if there's any leak, trust me, you won't be warranted. They expect the installer to really look at it to make sure it is all okay before they cover this equipment back again, and then a proper setup to do the starting. So I'm going to just cover it, and then we'll give it a start. Okay, so front cover installed, unit installed. So this unit is good now, and it's all tested, it's all working. So everything is well installed as per the manufacturer recommendation, so specification, so which is all done. So if you have any question, please put your question in. We will look at it and reply. And please subscribe to this channel. Thank you.